हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ योर सिक्सटीन्थ लेक्चर एंड फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ यूनिट 3, आइसोथर्मल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन डायग्राम्स। दैट इज, दिस इज़ द डायग्राम बिटवीन टाइम एंड द टेम्परेचर। व्हाट इज़ द इफेक्ट ऑफ टेम्परेचर विद रेस्पेक्ट टू टाइम। तो आइसोथर्मल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन डायग्राम, ऑल्सो नोन एज टाइम टेम्परेचर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन डायग्राम, आर प्लॉट्स ऑफ टेम्परेचर वर्सेज टाइम, यूजअली ऑन द लॉगरिथमिक स्केल। दे आर जनरली फॉर्म from percentage transformation versus time measurements and are useful for understanding the transformation of an alloy steel at elevated temperature. An isothermal transformation diagram is only valid for one specific composition material and only if the temperature is held constant during the transformation and strictly with rapid cooling to the temperature. Though usually used to represent transformation kinetics for steel, they also can be used to describe the kinetics of crystallization in ceramics or other materials. The time temperature precipitation diagram and time temperature embrittlement diagram have also been used to represent kinetic changes in steel. The isothermal transformation diagram or the C curve is associated with mechanical properties, microstructures, microconstituents, and heat treatment in carbon steel diffusion transformation like austenite transforming to a cemented and ferrite mixture can be explained using the sigmoidal curve. For example, the beginning of pyrolytic transformation is represented by the pyrolyte starts PS curve. The transformation of complete at PI curve nucleation requires an incubation time. The rate of nucleation increases and the rate of micro constituent growth decreases as the temperature decreases from the liquidus temperature, reaching a maximum at the bay or nose of the curve. Therefore, the decrease in diffusion rate due to low temperature offsets and the effect of increased driving force due to greater difference in free energy. As a result of the transformation, the microstructures pyrolyte and bainite form. Pyrolyte forms at higher temperature and bainite at lower temperature. Austenite is slightly undercooled when quenched below eutectoid temperature. When given more time, stable microconstituent can form ferrite and cementite. Coarse pyrolite is produced when atom diffuses rapidly after phase that form pyrolite nucleate. The transformation is complete at the pyrolyte finish time. However, greater undercooling by rapid quenching result in formation of martensite or bainite instead of pyrolyte. This is possible provided the cooling rate is such that the cooling curve intersects the martensite starts temperature or the bainite start curve before intersecting the PS curve. The martensite transformation begin a diffusion less shear transformation is represented by the straight line of the martensite start temperature as shown in the diagram. A continuous cooling transformation phase diagram is often used when treating steel. These diagrams are used to represent which type of phase changes with occur in a material as it is cooled at different rate. These diagrams are often more useful than time temperature transformation diagram because it is more convenient to cool materials at a certain rate than to cool quickly. The types of continuous cooling diagram. There are two types of continuous cooling diagram for particular purpose. Type A, this is plot beginning with the transformation start point, cooling with a specific transformation fraction and ending with a transformation finish temperature for all products against transformation time for each cooling curve. Type 2, this is plot beginning with the transformation start point, cooling with specific transformation fraction and ending with transformation finish temperature for product against cooling rate or bar diameter of the specimen for each type of cooling medium. A cooling curve is a line graph that represents the changes of the phase of matter, typically from a gas to a solid or a liquid or to a solid. The independent variable is the time and the dependent variable is temperature. Below is an example of a cooling curve used in casting. यहाँ दिखाया गया है कि पहले सॉलिडिफिकेशन होता है, धीरे धीरे लिक्विड डाउन होता है, लिक्विड टेम्परेचर डाउन होता है लिक्विड स्टेट में, उसके बाद सॉलिडिफिकेशन होता है, फिर सॉलिड स्टेट में क्या होता है टेम्परेचर धीरे धीरे डाउन होना लगता है. द इनिशियल पॉइंट ऑफ द ग्राफ इज द इनिशियल पॉइंट ऑफ द ग्राफ इज स्टार्टिंग टेम्परेचर ऑफ द मैटर हियर नोट्स एट द पोरिंग टेम्परेचर. यानी कि पोरिंग टेम्परेचर जब हम डालते हैं उसे मेटल को मेल्ट करके, तो उसका टेम्परेचर मोर देन 1600 डिग्री सेल्सियस होता है. उसके बाद क्या होता है धीरे धीरे वो स्लोली क्या होता है कूल डाउन होने लगता है. तो लिक्विड फेज़ में क्या होता है टेम्परेचर डाउन होने लगता है. आफ्टर 1500 डिग्री सेल्सियस क्या होता है सॉलिडिफिकेशन स्टार्ट होता है. डिफरेंट डिफरेंट फेजेस में सॉलिडिफिकेशन हो जाता है, फिर सॉलिडिफिकेशन के बाद क्या होता है टेम्परेचर धीरे एट सॉलिडिफिकेशन जो होता है वो कांस्टेंट टेम्परेचर पे होता है. उसके बाद टेम्परेचर क्या होता है धीरे धीरे दोबारा डिक्रीज होने लगता है और धीरे धीरे एम्बियंट टेम्परेचर तक पहुँच जाता है. द इनिशियल पॉइंट ऑफ द ग्राफ इज द स्टार्टिंग टेम्परेचर ऑफ द मैटर हियर नोटेड एज द पोरिंग टेम्परेचर. When the phase changes occurs, there is a thermal arrest. That is the temperature stays constant. यानी कि temperature constant रहता है, temperature change नहीं होता है. This is because the matter has more internal energy as a liquid or gas than in the state that is in cooling too. The amount of energy required for a phase change is known as latent heat. Phase change के time पर जो heat release होती है, heat gain जो होती है उसे क्या बोलते हैं लेटेंट हीट. द कूलिंग रेट इज द स्लोप ऑफ कूलिंग कर्व एट एनी पॉइंट. द काइनेटिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ ग्लास फॉर्मेशन वाज डेवलप्ड बाय गुस्ताव टेनमे 85 ईयर एगो. अकॉर्डिंग टू हिज अजम्पशन ए ग्लास कैन बी फॉर्म बाय कूलिंग इफ द कर्व्स ऑफ अ टेम्परेचर डिपेंडेंसी ऑफ न्यूक्लिएशन एंड द ग्रोथ आर सिग्निफिकेंटली सेपरेटेड. The tendency of a metallic alloy to form a glass is usually characterized by the glass forming ability. Glass forming ability को बोलते हैं short में GFA, which corresponding to a critical cooling rate beta at which no crystallization occurs during cooling from the melting point after cooling beta. The temperature below the glass transition region the material is expected to form a monolithic glass, that is a glass whose atomic structure is complete amorphous. The structure of the glass can be changed by annealing in it is the glassy state or the varying to the cooling rate during the formation. Another kinetic phenomena is the critical heating rate at which the glass does not crystallize upon heating. It may be expected that beta, because nucleation is much more dominant at deep undercooling, that is the maximum of the nucleation rate is at lower temperature than the maximum of the growth rate, and the critical size of the nucleus may be decreased at lower temperature. The composition between the glass formation and nucleation is a general phenomena and occurs not only in rapid quenched metallic alloy but in various classes of metastable material with different type of bonding. While glass formation is relatively rare in the metallic alloy and polymers. So this is about the first lecture of unit 3rd. आज के लेक्चर में इतना ही. नेक्स्ट आगे हम अगले लेक्चर में डिस्कस करेंगे अबाउट दिस. ओके, थैंक यू.